What's up, y'all? It's your boy, Matt Big Body Colay. This shit right here is a Big Body production, y'all. I'm gonna do something a little different than normal, man. I know a lot of times y'all be on my channel, y'all see some of the shit that I say. And a lot of times shit that I say, majority of the time shit that I say, is some downright straight up shit that the average person is scared to say because they worried about their channel getting flagged, or the average person just won't say because they worry about the character, or because shit is deemed as inappropriate, they want to keep it correct. So, fuck all that. You know, I'm going to get into some shit here. As you heard, that was David Ruffin in the background. Want to walk away from love. You know, that's when he performed back in the 70s on the Soul Train show. A lot of y'all, some of y'all might not know about all that, man. You know, a lot of, especially you millennial motherfuckers, man. But anyway, yeah, man. So, you know, I'm currently dealing with a situation where, you know, I'm going to use my situation as an example for future situations for people that are going through shit, man. You know, when you got somebody out there that you truly love and you be feeling, but just a lot of times shit don't go right or shit don't sit well to your liking, or you got motherfuckers all in your business, or you got motherfuckers that like to sidestep and throw little shit, little spurts of shit in there, and, you know, it kind of, it bothers you. As a person of certain character, or when somebody gets in between y'all shit, it bothers you. And a lot of times it's best to address it right then and there. But, you know, some people, some individuals don't have the fortitude or the backbone to sit there and say the shit right then and there. Then sometimes you try to save face and not ruin the moment and just hold on to shit. Now, me personally, a situation that came across about a week or two ago, and somebody had said something out of turn when me and my lady were having my former lady was having a discussion, and it got real ugly. Some words was exchanged, but I noticed in the midst of all that, the person who was saying the shit was spilling out some private shit that I know only exists between me and, you know, me and the lady. So I get it. Okay, sometimes when a heated moment go down, you need your girlfriend to lean on and talk to. But when your girlfriend gets out of line, gets out of turn, and starts saying some shit, you, as the person, especially the person who claims that you love that motherfucker, you should check that bitch right then and there. Me, as a nigga, if my motherfucking niggas was to say something to my woman at the time me and her was going through some shit, I'm going to check that right then and there. Yo, my man, shut the fuck up. That's my fucking woman. Nah, ain't none of that going down, nigga. Because at the end of the day, still going to deal with each other. It's obvious. Or at the end of the day, she's still going to come back around. I'm going to come back around. So you need to shut the fuck up. I appreciate what you're doing, but I need you to dead that. Like, now I got this. A lot of times, you know, a lot of times a man is also always looking for his woman, to know that backbone from his woman, you know. And a woman should already know, because the natural sciences of a man is to provide, protect, and lead. So a woman should already know she's dealing with a man, not a male, a man. A man got her back. You know what I mean? Like I told my chick back in at one point, you know, I don't give a fuck what the fuck you go through with whoever the fuck it is, whether it's your baby dad, whether it's God, I don't give a fuck. I got you. I got your back. Win, lose, or draw, I got your back. I'm not going to let nothing out of turn come in the middle between me and you. But, you know, as the years go on and shit build up and gather, you know, you can only put up and deal with so much. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm far from perfect, because I got a lot of shit with me myself that I'm sure that she's been able to deal with or put up with as well. But, you know, when shit's not addressed and brought to the table right then and there, or shit's kind of like waved off as if you don't want to be bothered with it now because it just going to seem like it's going to cause confusion later on. When shit like that ain't addressed, then you still have confusion resting around. So when a heated moment comes up again, then the shit just gets all combobulated and fucked up and shit. And it's just a mess. But the main important thing is this. When you're dealing with somebody, you got time in with that person, and y'all know each other's ins and outs and what triggers each other, and you should know the do's and don'ts with each other. I ain't saying it's going to be a perfect situation at all times, but when you got to keep revisiting shit old shit or similar shit that you know don't even sit well, you got to keep coming back to that shit. That shit get aggravating, man. And, you know, when you really love that person, you know, sometimes to keep things, and I know sometimes it's going to hurt, but to keep things at ease to where it, y'all break even, sometimes you got to walk away, man. Because I like, me personally, if I feel like I got to beat the shit out of you or your company, and I got shit to lose, man. I came from a fucked up position and redefined my past to where I'm decent and still in the making now. And I'm not trying to fuck that up and go backwards. So sometimes it's best to just walk away from this shit, man. And don't get me wrong, it'll hurt. And it don't mean that we can't revisit shit and still speak cordially with each other down the line. But to keep the healthiness and the sanity amongst each other, sometimes it's best to walk away, because I'm going to be real with you. A man don't require much from a woman, man. And I say this on a disgusting way, and I'm going to say it on a professional way. Most of us men, majority of us men, we just want you to fill our guts and empty our nuts. You know, sex us, feed us, and give us a little bit of attention, we good. But on the back end of it, on a professional note, you know, a lot of times a man just wants to know and feel like, no matter what, his woman's there by his side. She got him as far as just being there. The man's going to do the rest of the footwork as far as build the motherfucking white picket fence, put the car in the driveway, make sure the bills is paid, and dick you down all good. You just need to make sure your woman's going to be, you always want to feel secure like your woman's going to be there. And I'm going to tell you like this to you modern day women, or you next level women that are coming up in the game. As long as you make your man or nigga or whatever the fuck you want, title you want to give him, whatever, as long as you make him feel as you're there and he's got nothing to worry about, there's nothing that that man won't give you. As long as your man knows you got him and you're there, not necessarily mean a material wise, just that you're there and you're his ride or die. And that shit ain't even got to be questionable. Just know, this is my bitch. A lot of times y'all get it thrown out of context. You hear the word bitch and think that it's on some other. No. A lot of times when I say, or when a man says, yeah, this is my bitch, like this is my, like my holster on my hip, like this is mine, this is my one. When a motherfucker can't feel that, then it starts to put, you know, little shit in the game to where you gotta sit back and recite some shit and look at what's going on. If I feel as that my lady is more against me than with me, then I gotta sit back and reevaluate some shit, you know. And on a personal level, and the shit was bothering me along with some other shit. And I just finally said, you know what, fuck it, I gotta let this go, because I honestly didn't feel that she was there for me the way I wanted her to be there for me. And then not only that, she wasn't making no power moves with herself to show me, like, okay, we're going to move forward. I'm moving, making moves, moving forward. You're going to make some moves, move forward. As long as you're doing what you're doing, I'm doing what I'm doing, we come together, we're going to be an unstoppable force. It felt more like I was just moving forward on my own. And when she come around, you know, it's idle time. But when she's gone, I'm back on my grind. I'm back on my grind. Not we're on our grind. I'm back on my grind. Not saying she's a lazy chick. It's just like the pieces of the puzzle weren't lining up together. So it's almost like you ask yourself, what's the point of fucking if we can't establish or build something together? Why should I waste my time and energy and invest in something with someone if we're not going to collaborate and build something on the same page? Why? Like I said from the beginning, I'm redefining my past. I fucked up in the beginning with myself and where I could have been behind chasing nonsense and dealing with that shit in the street. I had a fucking reality check, of course, because you know what comes with that type of shit. Either death, jail, or just fuck shit. And luckily, mine was incarceration. I came back, turned things around, and I'm getting on my feet. A lot better than I expected. A lot better than other people expected. Because a lot of motherfuckers ain't even want to see me succeed. But fuck them. I can't worry about what somebody else is worried about with me. I got to focus on me. But when you got a partner in your corner, and you feel that partner's in your corner, she ain't going nowhere, and you feel she got your back no matter what it may be, there's nothing that you won't do. And I got to give it to her. She played a major role. She stuck around. She hung in there for some key parts. But there was that one thing that stuck out, along with some others, but that one main thing that really made me look at it like, you know what? I gotta let this go, man. All this time invested, and I can't even get the point of you silencing some shit at the moment or checking a motherfucker at the time. Like, nah. You know what? And there's no love lost. I was a little angry. I said some things. Yeah. Because you know what? Deep down inside, an average man won't show it, or average man won't express it and tell it to the world. Because right now I'm on social media with it. I was a little hurt on the inside. Like, damn, you ain't check this bitch? Really? Like, fuck the fact that you think that y'all friends or whatever, or cousins, whatever the fuck you want to title you. You ain't check this bitch right then and there to check this bitch. Like, it ain't no you waiting all that. Nah, no, because at the end of the motherfucking day, if that bitch fall off the face of the motherfucking earth, the love that I got for you is gonna grow bigger and stronger than what the fuck she can offer you. And if we're on the right track with each other, I'm going to throw you on my back and carry you before she will. But fuck all that. It's just some food for thought to you chicks out there that think y'all doing it, or you trying to figure out why can't you land a good man, or why nigga. And let's be for real. Majority of us men, niggas, we ain't shit. We got our ways with us. But I tell you, the key to keeping us solid and a standstill, play your position as a woman to make your man feel like a man. Let your man be a man, but make him feel like a man. Also help him understand and feel that you ain't going nowhere and you got him. I guarantee you that nigga give you the motherfucking hair out of his pores if it has some value to it. But I'm just saying, it is what it is. You can take it how you want it. I'm only going to give it to you straight up. I'm not going to sit here and talk about something that I'm not sure of. I'm only going to tell you off of life situations and dealing with some shit and going through some shit and actually just being a part of some shit. It is what it is, man, but you ain't got to believe me because life is the best teacher. If you don't want to believe me or even take heed of any piece of thing I said, let the world show you. But other than that, hey, look, it's your boy, Matt Big Body Cole. No fucks given, no holds barred. I'm throwing it the fuck out there. It is what it is. Later, y'all.